Animals have different coping mechanisms to withstand their harsh environment and to protect themselves against predators. So let's have a look at these unique yet useful adaptations that enabled these animals to survive in different conditions, from freezing temperatures at the poles to the blazing heat of the desert. The last one will grant you a visit to the dentist. But before we start, make sure to subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon for more exciting videos. Number 10. Wood frogs freeze their bodies. You may know that bears hibernate during the winter, as do snakes, groundhogs, and bats. But did you know that wood frogs can actually freeze their blood during the winter season? Yeah, that's right. Wood frogs are the only frogs found north of the Arctic region, and thanks to an antifreeze-like chemical in their blood, they can stop their hearts and form ice crystals inside their body. To achieve this semi-frozen state, the creatures build up high concentrations of glucose, up to 10 times the normal amount, in their organs and tissues. The sugar solutes act as cryoprotectants, preventing their cells from shrinking or dying. To survive the winter, up to 60% of wood frogs' bodies freeze solid. They also stop breathing and their heart stops beating. This allows them to survive temperatures as low as minus 80 degrees Fahrenheit. And when spring arrives, they thaw out and come back to life, and you can see them hopping around in summer. Number 9. Kangaroo rats survive without ever drinking water. Have you ever thought of surviving without drinking water? Probably not, because you don't have to. But unfortunately, that's not the case with kangaroo rats. They have to survive in the desert where there is little or no water. So, what do? Kangaroo rats are perfectly acclimatized with their harsh environment in the desert. Their amazing ability to survive without ever drinking water makes them perfectly adaptable to the surroundings, so either water is available or not. Not a problem for kangaroo rats, as they obtain moisture from the seeds they eat. They have exceptional hearing ability, and they can even detect the stealthy sound of an impending owl from miles away. These rodents can also jump up to 9 feet, which helps them avoid predators. Number 8. Antarctic fish have antifreeze proteins in their blood. Meet the notothenioids. Did I say it right? A group of more than 120 marine fish species, most of which are native to Antarctic waters. These fish have exceptional proteins in their bloodstream that prevent them from freezing. These antifreeze proteins, as they are commonly known, bind to tiny icy crystals in their bodies, inhibiting further growth. Most marine fish from temperate and tropical regions don't have antifreeze proteins and would freeze to death in the frigid Antarctic waters. That's because the water temperature, 28 degrees Fahrenheit or minus 1.9 degrees Celsius, is below the freezing point of their blood. This adaptation is so extraordinary that it helps explain why these fish make up 90% of the fish biomass of the region. Number 7. African bullfrogs create mucus homes to survive the dry season. The African bullfrog lives in the savanna of Africa, where it gets very hot and dry. When a frog is out of the water, mucus on its skin helps it breathe by dissolving oxygen from the air. So, to prevent its skin from drying out in the hot African climate, the African bullfrog buries itself 6 to 8 inches underground. It then creates a mucus membrane, which hardens into a cocoon. Sounds creepy, but not if you have to choose between being creepy or being alive. The frog can stay in this cocoon for up to 7 years while it waits for rain. When rain does arrive, the moisture softens the mucus sac, waking the frog up and signaling the start of the rainy season, the time when the frog breeds and is most active. Number 6. Cuttlefish blend into their surroundings. Just like a chameleon changes its color according to the surroundings, the skin of cuttlefish also changes its color to avoid predators. There are special elastic pigment sacs called chromatophores that help in this color-changing mechanism. Cuttlefish frequently use this adaptive camouflage to blend in with their environments. They can match the colors and surface textures of their surrounding environments by adjusting the pigment and appearance of their skin. If you observe the cuttlefish swimming around with its changing color patterns, it is one of the most amazing and comforting scenes. They can perceive how much light is being absorbed into the environment and then use that information to mimic it with their own pigments. Their skin also has papillae, which let cuttlefish appear rigid like coral. Together, these features allow cuttlefish to escape predators as well as sneak up on unsuspecting prey. Number 5. Tube worms turn toxic water into food. Scientists long thought that life couldn't exist at hydrothermal vents deep in the ocean. But in 1977, they found giant tube worms living among the Galapagos Rift, 8,000 feet below the ocean surface. These tube worms are surrounded by total darkness in their habitat, and they live in water filled with toxic gas and acid. These creatures have no stomach, gut, or eyes. Instead, they are bags of bacteria with heart-like structures and reproductive organs. The bacteria inside the worms use the toxic hydrogen sulfide in the water, which would kill most other animals, as an energy source to produce carbohydrates. Number 4. Okapi have scent glands on their feet. Though sometimes called forest giraffes, this creature doesn't look like a giraffe. It does have a long tongue, but it has the body of a horse and its legs have stripes like a zebra. Okapi is solitary and territorial. They have scent glands on their feet that spread sticky, tar-like territory markings to alert others of their region. Males also mark their territory with urine. On rare occasions, okapi joins together to eat in small groups. During this time, okapi may groom each other and play together. They reside in the Democratic Republic of Congo, where it's very hot and predators, such as leopards, are always lurking. To stay alive, the okapi has three key adaptations. First, they have scent glands on their feet to mark their territory. Second, they have infrasonic calls which allow them to communicate with their calves without predators hearing their call. Finally, they have 14 to 18 inch long tongues which can be used to wash their eyes and ears. Okapi also has thick, oily fur that keeps them dry when it rains. Number 3. Camels block sand, heat, and starvation. Camels are often called the ship of the desert, but things are not that easy for this giant creature. They have to survive in the furious heat as well as sandstorms that are the essential part of life in the desert. It is easy to think that camels are made for the sand, but in reality, they've successfully adapted to the harsh desert environment over millions of years. Camels have long eyelashes and a third eyelid to keep sand out of their eyes and wide feet to distribute their weight evenly on the sand. They have thick fur in sun-facing parts of their body for shade, and thin fur in other places to allow heat to easily escape their body to cool off. And don't forget their signature hump, which is full of fat that they can metabolize when there is no food or water around. Number 2. Fenic fox and their big ears. These foxes are adapted to live in the desert. They have the largest ears relative to their body size of any member of the caned family, which they use to dismiss the heat and track down prey underneath the sand. They are also the palest of all foxes, giving them excellent camouflage. Heavily furred paws provide traction when running in the sand, while also offering protection from the extreme heat of the terrain. Fenic foxes are also capable of going for long periods without consuming water, a key adaptation to survive in the desert. They are able to hydrate through the fox's thick fur coat, also acts as insulation during cold desert nights. Number 1. Javelina and their tough mouth. The peccary, or javelina, has a tough mouth and specialized digestive system, which enables it to chomp down on prickly pear cactus pads, one of their favorite foods, without feeling the effects of the plant's thousands of tiny spines. As a bonus, using cactus as a food source is a great way to supplement water intake, as the spiny succulents are absolutely loaded with the stuff. One key adaptation for survival is the living system of javelinas. They usually live in form of social groups. The average family group or social group is normally 10 or fewer members, but it can be as large as up to 50 members in some cases. Each group protects the territory, including their feeding and sleeping areas. They communicate with their own group members as well as other groups by using their senses of smell and sounds. So, that was the list of some unique animal survival adaptations. Which one is the most intriguing for you? Do let us know in the comments section and stay tuned for more amazing videos. See you on the next one!